Hello friends, my name is Masood. Today we shall discuss about a topic that what is the concept of a buffer in project management. And today's topic is very interesting and very important with respect to project management, especially if you are a student of project management or you are planning to give exam of PMP. So this is an important topic for you. So let's start. First of all, I request to please subscribe to my YouTube channel and click on the bell option as well so that my new videos can reach to you. So let's start, friend. Friend, what is basically a buffer in project management? Friend, project buffer is the extra time you add to a task, project activities, so that even if it get delayed, it will not affect the overall project schedule. The buffer adjusted dates then become binding deadlines you communicate to your team. Okay, so that is the main concept of a project buffer. Now, example, just try to understand the concept of project buffer from this example. For example, just take an example that you are a project manager and you are building a bridge over a river, for example, and the engineer who is working with you, who is a team member, and he is basically working on the drawings of the building, and you know that as per the authorities that you have to submit the drawings to the authorities by, for example, 13th June, for example, 13th June. Actually, now theoretically what you can do, like, you can give the deadline to engineer who is making the drawings that he has to submit the drawings on 29th June, so that you can submit it on the 30th June. But actually try to understand from here that is it true? Like, for example, if something bad happened, like, for example, your engineer gets sick and he may not be able to submit, like, or for example there is some issue on the PC of the engineer and his PC crash, or you notice a serious mistake in the drawings one day before submission. So what you will do in that case? Obviously, friend, obviously you will not will not accept. That's why you factor in sufficient buffer of that, let's say 1 week. The project task create drawings before needs to be finished by 23rd of June. For example, that actual deadline was 30th of June. Now you are giving a deadline to your engineer to 23rd of June, like you are taking a buffer of 7 days, so that if anything bad happened, like, for example, the engineer gets sick, for example, 1 day or 2 day he takes a leave, so there is a buffer of a 7 day. Actually, if something goes wrong along the way, you and your team still have time to turn things around and meet the submission date. Okay, so here the 7 days are basically the buffer, actually. Okay, so that is the main concept. Just take an as an example, like task 1 task 2, and this is the buffer. Actually, this is the, like, for example, this is the 7 days of buffer here. So that is the main concept of a project buffer, that if anything goes wrong, if anything goes bad, like your engineer gets sick or he is not available for 1 day or 2 day, anything happen, any emergency can be happened, so still you have a 7 days buffer, and you due to all those reasons your project will not be delayed. Okay, like, for example, if any activity in that way, if that activity gets delayed, so your project will not be delayed. Okay, now there is a question that do we always need a buffer? No, it is not true that we always need a buffer. It is not true. It depends on whether a specific project task is connected to another task, so that it needs to be finished first before the other task can start. So the answer of the question that do we need always need a buffer? No, we don't always need a buffer. It depends on the situation, it depends on the scenario. So friend, thank you, thanks a lot for watching the video. I hope you like this video. If you like it, please share it with your friends and colleagues, and thanks a lot for watching the video. Thank you, friends.